I, as a chemist here at NRL, study volatile compounds that make up odors that canines might detect for explosives or even narcotics or human tracking. So what we want to do is, while the humans are working on making better and better instruments, we want to work also on making better and better canine detectors. Everybody is concerned right now about safety in public places. All kinds of different threats are out there. We hear about them on the news all the time. Canines, on the other hand, are fantastic at all the different types of explosives as long as they're trained properly. So when you do research on the type of training aids, the odor coming off the training aids, how dogs are learning, anything along that nature, it helps better understand how dogs might be learning wrong or being trained wrong. And thus, in the end, it will help improve detection. So if the dog is training on a different compound than what you think that they are training on, they might not find the target in a real scenario. But if you understand what odor is coming off your training aids, then you have a better chance of getting that target in real life. So I developed here at NRL the mixed odor delivery device, which is this really simple little box here. So we have spaces to hold up to 4 different vials. These will each be containing a different homemade explosive component. So for example, this one might have ammonium nitrate and this one might have fuel oil. You can change the ratio very simply by not reweighing. One of the things that we don't want is in the field is to have to go and weigh out different amounts of ammonium nitrate or fuel oil in order to change the ratio. So you change the ratio by putting extra vials in here. So perhaps you might have 1 ammonium nitrate vial and 3 fuel oils, or vice versa. You can also really easily change the amount of odor coming out of a single vial by putting a lid with a restricting hole on it. And that will lower the amount coming out of this vial. So once you have the odors coming out, they're coming out of the vial separately and they enter this neck. In the neck is where the odors mix and the dog samples at the top of the neck. So the dog is sampling mixed odor. So as you can see, this is a bowl-shaped. The reason why it's bowl-shaped is so the dog actually has to bring its nose to it. And it is made out of PVC, which is an absorbent material. That doesn't seem logical that you would want an absorbent material for your vapor, but we actually do because it helps pool the odor in this area, making the dog actually come to it and finding the source of the odor. So another feature we have, so you have the open neck here, this can be the greatest amount of odor that can come out. We also have restricting plugs. You can see here it has little feet on it. The feet create little gaps so you can change the amount of odor coming out. And we have restricting plugs with different size feet creating different size gaps and thus different amounts of odor coming out of the top. So that's a basic mod. So what I would hope overall is that canine detection and science continue to work together. So I'm a chemist, so I look at odor, but there's also behavioral scientists that look at learning in dogs. There's veterinary issues also of a concern, and I hope that all these fields continue to work together to better the canines. We need to have more knowledge of the best ways to train, the best types of training aids, and then you're going to get the most proficient dog.